Their 30 raven daughters flew swiftly over the rooftops and sailed towards freedom, leaving the torn threads of metal from their cages below, for the evil eye, which as promised, had already been cast. For most of that morning, the path of freedom seemed the only choice. Darting through the air, it was not long before Tom saw the last of their tails, fleeing between the houses. Tom could feel his stomach twist in resentment, because for him, their escape was nothing but an indication of their cowardice and betrayal. They had left him and the 15 Dark Brothers. No attempt had been made to save them. Such bitterness they must have had. He cast his eyes down upon the fat black hens that sat upon the chest, where each night he made their cotton wool beds. For the first time, he was able to see the truth in their eyes. Filled with salty tears, these eyes showed more sentiment than the cold, gritty eyes he was used to. Thinking of their eyes and the colours they had shown him in the past, he saw himself for the first time as he really was, those grit eyes showing a reflection of their black insect minds that lay behind them. These self-seeking minds he had been a victim for the first These self-seeking minds, he had been a victim from the first winter they flew into his garden. Their broken wings mended, they failed to leave, and found their way into his room, and into the chest that they now slept in. Long since their days of flight, they were now unable to join their families in the sky for different reasons. Their bulging, heavy bellies now prevented them taking the air. All day they sat like a brood of fat hens in his drawers, there guzzling bacon, only sparing the rind. If the master's axe does cut such a clean path through the air, why have they been sleeping so soundly? How many knocks can that old chest stand?